Hello children, now in continuation to the description of flower in a flowering plant, you know, you are doing morphology of flowering plants. We will be taking another topic now, that is parts of a flower. You have calyx and corolla. Now calyx, the arrangement of calyx, that means sepals. The arrangement of sepals can be gamosepalous or polysepalous. Gamo means jointed, poly means separated. So gamo and poly are used as prefixes to tell us that gamosepalous is a condition where all the sepals are united, and polysepalous is a condition where all the sepals are free. And same is followed for corolla also. So you have gamopetalous and polypetalous. Gamopetalous, the petals are united. If the petals are united, you are going to get a bell-shaped structure. Okay, like you see in kaner, the yellow colored flower that you often find at the rim of various parks. You often play with it and put it on your fingers also, wear it on your fingers also, isn't it? That is kaner, Thivisia peruviana. And that flower is gamopetalous because the petals are jointed together. When all the petals are jointed together, they will definitely end up making a bell-shaped structure. So petunia, gamo is also of the same category at times. It has got varieties. And polypetalous, when it is free. Okay. Now, what is aestivation? Aestivation refers to the arrangement of these appendages or parts as whorls. How are they arranged? Right? That is also to be learned. Now, first one is velvate. I have written the example so that you might see it again and again and learn it. So velvate, the example is Calotropis. Actually, supposingly we have 5 petals. So our flower must be a pentamerous flower, isn't it? Now, they can be gamopetalous or polypetalous condition. But velvate aestivation tells us that all the petals are present. All of them are near to each other, but none of them are overlapping. So you can start with one petal. I wanted to show you here so that you understand how it goes. So you have petals like this. I have taken 5 petal flower. So I am going to stick to that. We have 5 petals here like this. So generally for petals, we use this kind of structure. We don't make flowers here. We make symbolic structure. So you have this kind of petal. Now can you see all the petals are present near to each other, but none of them is overlapping. Now this is polypetalous condition. If they are joint also, not overlapped, but joint. Gamopetalous condition could be just shown by joining them like this. So it will become gamo. Otherwise earlier it was polypetalous condition. Same is for sepals also. Same aestivation is used for sepals as well. Now another one is twisted. Now in twisted you have one side overlapping in all the petals. So you have to make it like this only. See, after making the skeleton like this, you need to make them overlapping. I'll show you how. They overlap like this. One inside, one outside. So one part of the petal will be inside and the other one will be outside like this. Now when you are making with pencil, you can use your pencil easily and can make it nicely. See. So now you can see, for every petal, one part is overlapped and the other one is overlapping. So this is known as twisted. The result will be a twisted structure. When you see the flower, the real flowers, you're really able to understand it properly. So next time when you hold a bouquet, kindly go through the flowers properly. So this is twisted. It is so different from this. Now if it is polypetalous but twisted, you can make it gamopetalous by just joining them like this. You need to put a join like this. Yeah, now they have become gemmo. Examples, ladyfinger, cotton, etc. Imbricate estivation, the third type, found in Casia, Fistula and Gulmohar. Okay, this is something where overlapping is random. Like one outside, one inside and three are overlapping. It means one petal or sepal is completely outside. Both of its ends are overlapping the other ones. Then one would be completely inside, like this. And rest of the three will be overlapping type. One, two, and the third one, like this. So you have got, look at it properly. One has got both the ends outside, isn't it? Both the ends are overlapping the other petals. One is completely overlapped because both of its ends are inside. So one is outside, one is inside, and three are overlapping means for another three, one of the side is outside, other one is inside, one side is outside, other one is inside, one side is outside and other one is inside. So this is how you explain imbricate estivation. Okay, as I've told you, examples are Casia and Gulmohar, and vexillary or papillinaceous. Now this is quite relevantly found in P, in the family of P. Okay, in the family of P, where you have one completely overlapping like this, and this is known as standard petal. Then two are present like this, they are wings. And then another two are keels, which are present in this way. And they are jointed like this. So you have three different kinds. One is standard petal. Then two are wings. They are termed as wings. And then last two are keels. So five of them are there, but you can see the variation. Now this kind of system is known as papillinaceous also, although the term is vexillary for them. And it will always be zygomorphic. It can't be actinomorphic. That is, when you will divide it, you can see here that if you will divide it like this, you will get two equal halves. So it is zygomorphic. But if you will divide it by any other plane like this, you won't get two equal halves. This is different, this is different. So only by one vertical division it will give two equal halves, and that is why this is zygomorphic. Okay. And then this is quite typical example of a very big family, leguminaceae, and that is why it is known as papillinaceous also. So you have four kinds of estivation in your syllabus: valvate estivation, twisted estivation, imbricate estivation and vexillary, or which is often known as papillinaceous. The examples are as equally important as the diagram or the way you draw.